Thanks for tuning in as we're continuing our series called Road Signs. In the series called Road Signs, we're looking at a principle. It's called the principle of the path, because all of us are on a path in life. But the principle of path is this. It's our direction, not our intentions, that determine our destination. It's the direction you're going, not the intention, not, hey, I want to be here, but I'm going to go this way, hopefully that I get here. And it's not that. It's direction, not your intentions, that determine your destination. And this past Sunday, we looked at a scripture. We looked at Proverbs chapter 27, verse 12. And this is what Proverbs 27:12 says. It says, "The prudent, the wise, the smart person, sees danger and takes refuge. But the simple keep going and suffer for it." And we looked at that verse because here we have two different people. We have two different decisions about the same thing, but we have two different outcomes to it. You see, the prudent, when they see danger, when they see a warning sign, like, you know, let's say you're driving down the road and you see like a sign that says bridge out. Okay, the smart person does what? Stops, okay, takes refuge, does something, takes action. But what does the simple person do? Man, they just keep going, man. They just ignore the sign. They just blow right through it. And maybe they even say something like this. You know, I probably should stop. It's probably not a good thing. But you know what? Hey, check this out, dude. I can do like a Dukes of Hazzard kind of deal. And we can just jump this thing. You know, and the Bible tells us that, you know, that simple, those kind of deal, that they ignore the warning signs, that we suffer for it. And that we suffer for it. And so we looked at four words. Four simple words that happen along the path. And we have to do something with these four words. The first word was action. The first thing we have to do, we have to take action. You see, we just can't sit on our butts and be lazy. You know, we have to get up and we have to do something. We just can't sit around and be bums. We have to take action. You know, some of the action we may have to take, you know, we may have to end a relationship. We may have to make a difficult phone call. We may have to do something here or do something there. And it's not comfortable, but we may have to do it. We have to take action. We just can't sit still. When we see the warning signs, we have to take action. Remember, the prudent, the smart person, when they see a warning sign, when those warning signs that God gives us, when we see that, what do? We need to take action before we get into a hard place. And the second thing is sacrifice. And we don't like that word. I mean, it's like a four-letter word to us here in the United States, because we really don't want to sacrifice anything, right? But it's going to take sacrifice. We're going to have to give something up. You know, it's like if you're trying to lose weight, you're trying to get in shape, you're going to have to give some things up. You're going to have to give up some of the foods you like to eat that aren't really good for you. You're going to have to do some things. You're going to have to make a sacrifice. Well, in order to live with this principle and on this principle, the principle of the path, you're going to have to take action first, and then there's going to have to be some sacrifice. There's going to have to be some sacrifice on your part. And the third thing is embarrassment. That's the third word. It's embarrassing to admit when you're wrong. You know, it's embarrassing to have to make a difficult phone call. There's some embarrassment to it because, you know, people are watching us. I mean, especially those who really know you, and they know, they see how you act, and all of a sudden now there's some embarrassment there. There's going to be some embarrassment. But you know, it's worth it, because the fourth word is relief. And that's such a great word, because relief is, we can sit back and we go, oh man, thank God I didn't go down that road. Thank God I made a decision. Because you see, so many of us, especially us adults, what? We can look back and go, man, if I wouldn't have done that. Or we say things, if I only... You know, why live a life with if onlys and all this other stuff? God gives us plenty of warning signs. We just have to pay attention to them. So what I want to challenge you with is this, is look at the road you're on. Look at the path you're going down. Is it taking you where you want to go? Are you headed in the direction that you want to be in? Or you're having these great intentions, but yet you're doing something completely different, hoping to get there. I hope through this series that we're doing, that some of us, we wake up and we realize we're headed someplace we don't want to be. And the Bible's very clear that we're going to suffer. There's going to be pain. We're going to suffer if we continue to stay on this path. So I want to challenge you. Is take a good, hard look at your path. Take these four words. Take action. Understand there's going to be some sacrifice. There's going to be some embarrassment. But guess what? there's also going to be relief. Wow. Why don't we live our lives that way? So let's do that. Well, let's take that challenge. New decade, take the challenge. Examine your path. See where you're going. And then take action. Hey, I love you guys. I can't wait to see you again this next Sunday as we continue this series, Road Signs. I'll see you next week, guys. Bye-bye.